Assalamu alaikum, respected viewers, peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. Welcome to the holy land of Kadhimia. Respected viewers, the rulers, the oppressors, those who oppressed the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, those who moved them, who made them travel from Medina to the different parts of the world, basically to Baghdad, to Samarra, to Iran also. Those rulers wanted to push away the effectiveness of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, the effectiveness of the Imams. They wanted to put the Imams out of their followers in order to have the opportunity to control everything, because at that time the Shias were increasing day after day. But subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never wanted for them to diminish or to erase the mention of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the remembrance of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam a matter of immortality. And those immigrations, this oppression that they were subjected to, they were transported from Medina to Baghdad, from Medina to Samarra, from Medina to Iran. All of that came in the benefit of spreading Shi'ism, subhanAllah. When the Imam alayhi salam, Imam al-Kadhim alayhi salam, moved from Medina to Baghdad, subhanAllah, he made a base for him in Baghdad. The numbers of Shi'as, the numbers of the lovers of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, increased in Baghdad. And also with Imam Muhammad Jawad, peace be upon him, when he moved to Samarra, the numbers of his Shi'as, the numbers of the lovers, of the followers of the Imam, increased at that place. And also with Imam al-Ridha, peace be upon him, he gained more followers in Iran than in any other place. And subhanAllah, you can see here in Baghdad, for example, the remembrance and the mention of Imam al-Kadhim. We have a grand mosque, a grand holy shrine that indicates the remembrance of Imam al-Kadhim, the remembrance of Imam Muhammad al-Jawad. But where is the remembrance of the Abbasiyin, of the Abbasi caliphs? There is no remembrance of them. There is no single shrine for them in Baghdad. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted for them, the matter of their immigration from Medina to the different parts of the world was a matter of spreading Shi'ism. Respected viewers, now we will speak about the immigration of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him, from Medina to Baghdad. It says here that al-Mansur was killed on 158 Hijri, and his son al-Mahdi came to power after him, of course, as a successor, as the next caliph. He adopted people, deceiving politics. That man, al-Mahdi, the son of al-Mansur, was a deceiving man, subhanallah. He was pretending the love for the Ahlul Bayt, but deeply inside of his heart, he was committing sins. The man set free the followers of the Imam. He set them out of prison, but deeply and undercover, he committed sins. The man was given money to the poets who curse Imam Ali, who curse the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. So he had two sides. He had two faces, dealing with the Shias, dealing with the Imams. He had two faces. One face, he was telling that he loved the Imams, he loved the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. But the other one, he was setting up all the bad matters that will affect the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. It says here that one spy of al-Mahdi informed him about the fame of the people's trinity. He told him that one spy told al-Mahdi, the son of al-Mansur, told him that the people are surrounding, are surrounding the Imam, and the Imam has so many followers in al-Medina. So out of jealousy, out of, for political purposes, the al-Mahdi set up you know, to imprison the Imam alayhi salam, and so on. The Imam met one of his companions and told him, "Don't worry, I will be back in a while." And you know, Al-Mahdi after a while set free the Imam. The companion then asked the Imam, the Imam's companion, asked Imam Al-Kadhim, "How did Al-Mahdi set you free, my lord?" So the Imam answered him that, Al-Mahdi dreamed of Imam Ali. Imam Ali, peace be upon him, came to Al-Mahdi in his dream, and furiously the Imam was telling him not to harm the Ahlul Bayt, not to harm the Imams, and Al-Mahdi, the son of Mansur, set the Imam for free. Al-Mahdi was, it says here, the narration says that Al-Mahdi was deeply corrupted man. He used to use the money, the Bayt al-Mal, you know, the Muslims' treasury. He used it for different purposes. He used it for luxurious purposes, for his palaces, for the luxury life. He also used a great amount of money. You know, particularly he spent 50 million dirhams in connection with the marriage of his son. He held a lot of parties, he held a lot of ceremonies just for one purpose, subhanAllah, the marriage of his son. They were deeply corrupted caliphs. They never matter, the poor people, the poor Muslims, never matter for them. SubhanAllah, they were deeply corrupted, and their revolution started in the name of the Ahlul Bayt. So on, the next caliph, and so on, the next caliph. Respected viewers, I will leave you now with live footages from the areas neighboring the Holy Shrine, and I'll be back to continue with the matter of immigration. How did the Imam, peace be upon him, immigrate from Medina to Baghdad? So stay tuned, my dear brothers and sisters.
هر شب تا سهر خدا خدا میکنم، تا صبح لبم و وقف دعا میکنم. چند سال که روزه هم و تنگ غروب، با ضربه ی تازیان با میکنم. روز روشن برا من شبیه شب تاره، زنجیری که دور گردن هر دی داره، مثل شبها میزنن من و روزا دوباره. مدام از چشم خیزم بارونه قم میباره، تشی تن من روی یک تخت پاره. غریبا 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 دستاشون میارن بارون غم از غربت من میبارن، رو پیکر من دسته گل میریزن، تو هفت کفن تن منو میذارن. من بمیرم حسن قربت شاه شهید من بمیرم، واسه پیکر مرده رو خاکا من بمیرم، واسه تشنه بر لب دریا تو انسان ها تا آخر همش مش میرم از ها، تو انسان ها تا آخر همش من میرم.
respected viewers, back to you from the areas neighboring the holy shrine of Al-Kadhimin. Peace be upon him, where the atmosphere is too clear. You know, the pilgrims are safely walking and going to the holy shrine to perform the pilgrimage rituals. Before we take that break, we were speaking about how the Abbasid caliphs deal with the Imam, peace be upon him. We spoke that after Al-Mansur was killed, his son Al-Mahdi, who pretended to be, doing good for the Ahlul Bayt, but deeply inside, he was setting all the, all the bad things for the Ahlul Bayt. He was giving money for the poets just to curse the Ahlul Bayt, alayhim as-salam. And then, after Al-Mahdi died, the narration says here that Al-Hadi, his son, succeeded him. In spite of the suffocation and the oppression on the Ahlul Bayt, alayhim as-salam, the Imam was, as usual, and as the rest of the Imams were dealing with their matters, you know, despite the oppression and despite the fact that the rulers are afraid of them, even though the Imams were peaceful, the Imams never thought of holding a revolution to repel the government or the rulers. Those people, the rulers, you know, were setting maka'id against the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. It says here that Al-Mahdi, in contrary to his father, he was deeply oppressing the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, on public, oppressing the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. So Al-Mahdi summoned that Imam Al-Kadhim has to move to Baghdad. The Imam has to move to Baghdad. So the Imam moved. It was very obvious that the Imam was obliged to move from Medina to Baghdad. Alhamdulillah, when the Imam moved to Baghdad, the Shias increased in Baghdad, and since the Imam is there, since the leader of the entire Muslim Ummah, the grandson of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his progeny was there, the Shias were getting the teachings, the Muslims were getting their teachings, and they were turning that, they came to realize the true fact about the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. They came to know who are the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. The Imam was involved in matters of fiqh, in matters of qada, hawa'aj al-mu'mineen, and going for the needs of the believers, going for the needs of Muslims, the charity and whatsoever. Alhamdulillah. So the Imam lived in Baghdad for a while, and then was the biggest part of imprisonment, 19 years. And that's how we can deeply state about the Imam al-Kadhim, that Kadhm al-Ghayd was one of his obvious, characteristics. He kept inside his pain, he kept inside his anger, despite the fact that he was oppressed by the rulers, despite the fact that that the Abbasid Khalifs were killing the Alawis, were oppressing them. And here we shed the light upon an incident which is called Fakh. At that time, there was an Alawi who's called Al-Husayn ibn Ali. He basically fed up with the fact that those rulers are always, oppressing the Ahlul Bayt for no reason, but they are the successors of the Holy Prophet. So Al-Husayn ibn Ali led a revolution with 300 men against Al-Mahdi. The 300 men basically controlled Medina and set a camp to control Mecca afterwards. But then the Abbasi army surrounded them and committed a massacre. Basically, 300 men, were most of them were slaughtered, and the rest of them were tied up and sent to the so-called caliph. He was a so-called caliph, basically, because a true khalifa, a true caliph, would never oppress Muslims. That's despite the fact that, the Ahlul Bayt and though, but a true Muslim can never oppress a Muslim. Though those rulers oppressed the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, and took their rightful place. They pretended to be the leaders of the Ummah. So the prisoners were sent to the so-called Khalifa, and the Khalifa just basically ordered to kill them. Was that, you know, as any Muslim would wonder, is it the morality of Islam to kill a prisoner? It is not the morality of Islam to kill a prisoner. The Prophet, peace be upon him and his progeny, the basic teacher where we get our teachings from, the Holy Prophet, the leader of the Ummah, the first leader of the Ummah, the best man on earth, the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made an entire, you know, chapters in his name and mentioned him in many verses in the Quran. The person who was revealed, the Quran, who the Quran was revealed to him, never oppressed his prisoners. Basically, in the Battle of Badr, there were a number of mushrikeen who were captured as prisoners. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him and his progeny, treated them well and told them, whoever teaches a Muslim how to write and read would be set free, and told the others, call your families to, you know, to be exchanged for things. So those people, that would be a sign, the incident of Fakh is a true sign that those so-called leaders, that those so-called khalifas were never a leaders of the Islam, were never leaders of the Islami Ummah. They oppressed the people in the name of the Holy Prophet. They oppressed the people in the name of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. And so on we see in our modern societies, so on in this world, we see rulers. Well, basically, let's go for Saudi Arabia. Those kings are ruling in the name of Islam, but they are never, subhanAllah, they never care for Islam. And they're misleading scholars. They make rulings just for them. Respected viewers, stay tuned. We will go in a short break and be back, you know, to have an interview with the servants of the pilgrims, and somehow the pilgrims will be also interviewed to express their feelings about the atmosphere, the general atmosphere of this pilgrimage. So stay tuned, my brothers and sisters, with live footages from the areas neighboring the holy shrines of Al-Kadhimin, peace be upon them. Stay tuned.
وانت اكفل الدين النبي يا موسى يا سما بحزنك خيمي يا موسى صح يا موسى زاير بحصنك انتصرت كل عالمي أعشق الصح للكاظم خادم على عينه بعد يا موسى يا موسى زاير بحصنك احتمي يا موسى انتصرت أعشق الصح للكاظم ارفع ليدك وياي يا موسى يا موسى دوار التاريخ الكتب شفتك لغز جدا صعوب والغدك اكبر جاهل والغدك اي زهدك يوضح الخبر به افتخار حتى الفخر كل من ينكر زائل كل من ينكر غير احمليت مثل القمر غير احمليت مثل القمر عباس بن فارس مضار غير احمليت عباس بن فارس مضار للدين كنت الكافل هو كفل ام الحزن دينك كفلت بالسجن قلبك لواء شايل قلبك لواء ها يا موسى هو الكفل بنت الأبي يا موسى انت سويت وانت الكل الدين النبي يا موسى يا سم بحزنك خيم يا مو صيح يا موسى زاير بحصنك انت صرت اعشق الصاح للكاظم يا موسى لو احكي عن مصيبتك روحي توين الغربتك يل ما توصف يومك يل ما توصف اي همك فلا يحمل بشر لكن خلودك لانتصر فزت بحور علومك فزت بحور لاحوا بك حتى الفلك ساعة السمد السوهلك لاحوا بك حتى ساعة السمد السوهلك غير يا موسى رسومك غير يا موسى انت جبل كيف انشلت فوق الرؤوس تشيعي على جمر همومك على جمر يا موسى
Back to you from the areas neighboring the holy shrine of Al-Kadhimin, peace be upon them. Before the break, we were talking about the imprisonment of Imam Al-Kadhim, peace be upon them. We also spoke about the incident of Fakh. Basically, there were many narrations that indicate the period of imprisonment of Imam Al-Kadhim, peace be upon them. Various narrations that indicate various, you know, various facts. One of the facts was the 19 years imprisonment, and the other one, according to the basic narration, more accurate narrations, says that the Imam was imprisoned 14 years at the time of Harun al-Rashid, until his martyrdom, until the time where Harun al-Rashid, you know, poisoned the Imam, peace be upon them. Respected viewers, in the meantime, we will interview a servant who a person who served the pilgrims. Please come here. My brother here is a servant of the pilgrims of Imam Al-Kadhim, peace be upon him. He will tell us some facts about the pilgrimage and the atmosphere and the services they provide and how do they feel. While serving the pilgrims of Imam Al-Kadhim, peace be upon them. Peace be upon him. Assalamu alaikum. How do you do? Alhamdulillah, fine. Could you please introduce yourself at the very beginning?
Yeah, okay. Yes.
Your name and where do you live? And what more could you work?
I am Wissam Rasul. I am working here for service to people for Ziyarat Imam Musa Al-Kadhim. I speak about this ziyarat. More people coming to moving for food. More people coming for moving food for to Imam in every city, different city in South Iraq, also north Baghdad, also Karbala. City coming to Ziyarat Imam. Me coming before 1 week for give service for these people here and give three meals.
Well, basically that is the services you are providing for the pilgrims, right?
Yeah. Give three meals in morning, give breakfast after and afternoon, and afternoon give lunch time, and at night give dinner, and between give some meals, drinks, cold drinks, and tea, and give some juice or water, cold water, give every time. For this, you see more people coming to Ziyarat Imam, because Imam more support for Islam in this time.
Also, the blessings of the Imam, peace be upon him.
Yeah.
You know, the support of the Imam to the Islamic Ummah.
To the Shia, and only about Shia, more people coming for another sex, and coming, join together for Imam. Me enjoy for give service. I have one service unit here. I give more every time I give a service for the more people.
So that's basically how do you feel? How your friends feel? Your friends, you know, the people who serve with you. How do they feel while they are providing these services?
Yeah, together working and give every time give service, enjoy and feels for give help any people coming for any people need for rest or need eating or need sleeping, have a house, open house in here, can he sleep in any time, in night or any time. And I give food every time for this people.
Could you please tell me the atmosphere of the pilgrimage? The people, how do they unite together? How do you see that during the pilgrimage?
That's good for together coming for more people, more service unit in south, in way north Baghdad, also in south Baghdad. More units have for give food, anything for need to people. And coming people to here, you know, some people coming by car, coming for food. For that. Give service for Imam. Imam very.
You know, the blessings of the Imam are helping you always. Could you please tell me about the security situation, the security around you? How do you feel about that? How do you feel secure in this area?
Yeah, I have security in three line for circle for Imam, anyway, in South Iraq, in South Kadhimia city, also north, also west and east. For that, I see very good security here, because every time also have come online, come with the control for Kadhimia city. Yeah. That's good, you know. And tomorrow this is for. Ziyarat Imam. You know, today, before 1 week, no have any explosion, no have any problem for security here. Yeah, alhamdulillah, yeah, for that. Yeah.
My brother here was, expressing his feelings. He said that they feel joy to provide the services for the pilgrims. He and his, and his companions, you know, his friends, while they're providing the service to the pilgrims, they feel very joyful because of the blessings of the Imam, peace be upon him. It is also that the blessings of the Imam that keeps everybody safe. He also mentioned the security stature. He also mentioned about the coexistence in the city during the pilgrimage. Respected viewers, stay tuned. We will be back in a short break. So stay tuned with live footages from the areas neighboring Al Kadhimain, peace be upon them, holy shrine. Stay tuned, dear brothers and sisters.
وصل ضريحك سيدي يا موسى ونطوفه يا موسى ونطوفه اي نوصل ضريحك سيدي يا موسى ونطوفه ويانا ما ميت عدل واحساسك تشوفه يا الكاظم وحبك فرض لا والله منعوفه يا الكاظم اسمك يظل بكل قلب ما تنمح حروفه ما تنمح حبك نمى واكثر يا موسى بن حبك نمى واكثر يا موسى بن يا غريب فدوة الله يا غريب صوت المحيط يا غريب يا غريب خادم على العين يا غريب الله احبابك احنا وشيعتك باسمك تسمينا ما خفنا من كل ناصبي احنا تحدينا من قبرك يشع الضوى يا موسى والينا من قبرك يا موسى والينا قيد شفوفك بالسجن يا سيدي وانا يا سيدي واللي يبغضك يخسر يا موسى بل واللي يبغضك صيح يا غريب يا غريب الله الله يا غريب صوت المحب صوت المحب
Assalamu alaikum, respected viewers. Back to you from the holy city of Kadhimia. As you know, we are in the areas neighboring the holy shrines of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him. The general atmosphere of the pilgrimage is, you know, safe, and everybody are enjoying, actually, the servants are enjoying their service. Their service to the pilgrims of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him. I have my brother here. He is a servant who was also enjoying the service of the pilgrims. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa
rahmatullah. Ismak wa minyan jai.
Wusam ibn al-Kadhim.
My brother's name here is Wusam, and he is from the holy city of Kadhimia. I will ask him now about the name of their service unit and what do they do to serve the pilgrims. أخي العزيز شنو اسم موكبكم وشنو الخدمات اللي تقدموها للزوار؟
موكب باب الحوائج بالشوصة الخدمي أربع وجبات غدا وعشاء غدا وجبتين وعشاء الحمد لله خير من الله.
الحمد لله.
الله يزيد ويبارك.
My brother here just said that their service unit is called باب الحوائج. The gates of fulfillment, and they provide three meals a day, basically breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The dinner, they provide two meals for dinner because of the large number of pilgrims. Now I will ask my brother here about how he feels while providing the service for the pilgrims. أخي العزيز شنو شعورك لما أنت تقدم الخدمة للزوار؟
والله يعني هو شعور ما ينوصف أنه أنت تيجي تخدم أهل بيت أمتنا أهل بيتنا زين يعني ما أعرف شو أوصف لك الشعور راحة نفسية
راحة نفسية الحمد لله شنو شعور زملائكم بالعمل؟
والله الكل متواجدين ويانا مناوب بالليل والصبح ناس تبات بالليل زين واجبات ناس الصبح وناس بالليل تبادلوها وموفرين الخدمة للزارين والحمد لله شكرا.
My brother just said that the feeling is unexpressible. He said that he can't express his feelings while providing the service for the pilgrims of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him. He and his colleagues, they are, you know, they made shifts, time shifts to serve the pilgrims. Some of them serve at morning, some of them serve at night, and even during the late night, the services still continue to the pilgrims of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon them. Peace be upon him. أخي العزيز, شنو الرسالة اللي تحب أن تقدمها للشيعة حول العالم؟
الشيعة حول العالم أنه ماخذين نظرة أنه إحنا هنا طائفية أنه شيعة ومسيح وناس تكره ناس وحرب بيناتنا, وهي هاي الحرب طائفية أمريكية إن شاء الله ما متواجدة بيناتنا, ومتواجدين ويانا الإخوان السنة والمسيحي اللي يجون يزورونه ويزورون الإمام زين, والحمد لله إن شاء الله شعب واحد موحد بإذن الله.
My brother just said that the message he wants to deliver to the respected viewers is that, you know, in the European country, in the Western countries, people think that the war in Iraq is basically a sectarian war. While basically, as he says, that the brothers from the different sects and religions are all live in peace in here. They all peacefully coexist together, respect one another, visit one another, and even people from other sects and religions are coming to perform the ziyarah rituals, the pilgrimage rituals to Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him, and Imam al-Jawad, peace be upon him. I will ask my brother about the date of establishment and the number of the servants and their procession and their service units. أخي العزيز, إيش وقت تأسس الموكب مالتكم؟ وإيش قد عدد الخدام بي؟
والله هو العدد يعني ماكو عدد محدد, ناس تجي خير من الله يعني, وايد يجون هالمنطقة الجوارين الأقارب زين يجون يخدمون ويانا زين, يعني ما أقدر أحدد لك عدد
يعني
محدد. يعني تقريبا بفد 50-60 نفر متواجدين للخدمة. وجبات ريق وغدا وعشاء. تأسس بعد 2003.
بعد 2003.
نعم.
My brother here just said that their service unit was established after 2003, and the numbers of servants who come to serve the pilgrims of Imam al-Kadhim and Imam al-Jawad, peace be upon them, are numerous. He said that people come and go because this service is a blessing of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam to the servants themselves. He said that relatives and neighbors are all coming together to provide those services. They all, you know, coexisting and helping one another to serve the pilgrims of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon them. Respected viewers, as you know, stay tuned. We shall inshallah have more live shows that will take the story of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him, that will tell the story of Imam al-Kadhim, peace be upon him, and also we will take the views of the take the views and how they express their feelings about the general atmosphere of the pilgrimage. And how do they feel about the situation in the pilgrimage? So stay tuned, dear brothers and sisters. I will leave you now with live footages, and inshallah to come more live shows from Al Kadhimia, holy city. Thank you very much, brothers and sisters.
يا موسى بن جعفر يا كعبة صبر أو تقصد لك الكونين مشاي إلك نقسم بنحر حسين هلا مشاي إلك نقسم بنحر حسين يا الحبك فرض يا سيد من الدين ويا القبرك روضه من الجنه يا القبرك روضه يا القبرك روضه من الجنه يا القبرك روضه من الجنه يا القبرك روضة من الجنة نقصد لك بلهفة وخلني تفجر نار الشوق بينا بكل وقت تسعر عشاق وننادي موسى بن عشاق وننادي موسى بن